Welcome back to the vote. I'm here with Paul Shellard from the National Education Union branch secretary there for Brighton Hove. COVID-19, the pandemic, you were saying in the first half how it's gone fairly smoothly. Cases have been low, which is a good thing. What about in terms of catching up? Any ideas about what schools are going to be doing in order to for kids to catch up, if they need to catch up at all, or are they just taking it easy? Is it going to be different for each school, I'm guessing, or what's the plan?
Well, it is going to be different for each school. I think one of the key things is that whole idea of catch up we consider to be a bit of a misnomer, because it's not the case that there can just be a break and then we can identify what education has been missed and then we can kind of fill those gaps. The whole experience of the pandemic has had such an impact on different communities, different families, that we are needing to make sure that there's a recovery model in schools. And that really is what has been accepted, I think, in the vast majority of schools. So as well as looking at the subject knowledge or the direct educational experience that's been missed, we're also, schools are prioritising issues to do with mental health, with making sure that there's effective transition, with dealing with issues that are perhaps you couldn't have predicted that they would be problematic, and in supporting, for instance, students who are in exam groups who might need particular support because they've suffered greatly in terms of their schooling since the beginning of the pandemic. So in terms of recovery, schools are making a big effort, but every time a government minister opens their mouth and starts talking about catch up, I think it just gives the completely wrong impression of what is happening and what should be happening in schools.